Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop.
Okay, so that was really, really easy. As you saw, it was just a matter of attaching it to the sled, took it off, and again, referenced those lines, pushed it through, kept my hands out of the way. The worst part about it was the blade had wasn't quite as high as I wanted it to, but you know what? I have a smaller... Okay, so we've got our stock cut to the width that we wanted. We just ripped it. And now we're going to attach it to the jig itself. Now, there's not really any good way to attach this, like with clamps, because we're going to be running it right up close near the blade. So the easiest way is to drill a hole through the stock. And this is part of the reason why we're going to make it, we want to leave the stock a little bit longer so that we have these areas that we can kind of play around with. So I pre-drilled a hole in there. And I'm going to go ahead and start to drill this screw through so that it'll be exposed and I can line it up with a corresponding hole that I've already pre-drilled in the jig. I want everything nice and flush so that when this baby rides through the blade, it's going to stay, you know, as perfectly square. We're still going to have to do a little touch-up work on the backside once we're done. Okay, that's locked in. That's not going anywhere. Okay, it still can move a little bit, but it's fine. Now, another thing is, when we made the jig, let me just move this out of the way a little bit. You see how there's kind of a, this is where the 20 degrees is going to come off. We want that 20 degrees to be right at the nose, right at the mouth of the plane itself. So I'm going to have the plane overhang just a little bit where the blade is going to run along this fence. So let's go ahead and move everything into position. And should have had this lined up just a little bit. There we go. That's good. Now, when I run this through, that screw is going to hold this in place, but the screw is out of the way of the blade. And my hands are well away from the blade. And all the action is going to hold it down. It's going to cut through here. And like I said, we'll probably have to clean it up a little bit once we made the finished cut. But majority of the work is done right here. We're almost done. So once again, let's go ahead and don the safety gear. Turn on the dust collector. Move these things out of the way so nothing's jiggling on the table saw. And we're ready to go. All right, we got our finished cut here. Oh, this darn dust mass. Let's go ahead and remove it from the jig. Wow, that looks nice. Looks better than the first time I did it with the prototype. Very, very happy with that. The key is to make sure that the stock runs very, very flush with the surface so that when the cut is made, you're getting a 90 degree cut all the way up. So let's go ahead and check this. Oh yeah. Wow, that's nice. Again, we're still gonna have to do a little bit of work, yep, with a hand plane or you know, whatever choice you can sand it, I guess, to get this nice and flat. It's a little off, but we'll take care of that in a second. But essentially, our plane is pretty much ready to go. We'll cut it to length, and then the next thing is gonna be to start attaching the equipment on here so that we can attach that blade and hold it in place. And we're pretty much at this point about 50% done. Okay, so we got the basic shape, and then we needed to refine the bed itself because when it came off the blade, well, it wasn't perfectly square to our reference side. We want to start with the side that we were flattening over on the jointer. So I went ahead and brought it over, and we didn't need to do too much to it. It really was in a very good position. We just needed to remove just a little bit of material. So I put it into the vise, and I grabbed my number 4, because like I said, I just wanted to refine it just a little bit and came in and just removed just a little bit of material. Now, I'm not going to do it again because I got it right in the position that I wanted. I went ahead and kind of took a couple of extra steps before we came into it. But it was just a matter of getting the piece clamped the right way and then just removing it. It was pretty easy also with using my low angle block plane. I was able to do that before because essentially, if you think about it, we are working more or less kind of with an end grain here. And then I also just, I didn't need to do too much, but I just needed to square up the end too. So that was just a matter of taking my square, wherever it is, and just kind of drawing a line. And again, just simply clipped it a little bit. It'd be nice if it's completely flat coming in on that angle to the bed or to the sole. But one problem with that is it could very easily chip and then it kind of catch with the material as it's going in. So I deaded it out a little bit and it's not quite completely at an angle. So that works out fine. Now, this is all ready to go. And oh, remember how I said I wasn't going to worry about, you know, cleaning up all the rough material and everything? I'll do that afterwards. Well, it's pretty obvious why. Since we took that angle off, we don't have to worry about all this being rough. And then there was just this little bit here where our hand is going to sit. So I used the number 4 smoother and got it all cleaned up. So, I mean, take a look. That's a nice looking piece. Oh, and look, I got a couple little holes in the side. Hey, that's kind of, unique. But anyways, what we're going to do next is we need to drill the hole for the cap iron for the screw that's going to hold that down. So we're going to have to head over to the drill press, and we're going to go ahead and take care of that step next. Okay, so we've got the piece, and I ended up bringing the drill press over here. It was just a lot easier. One of the nice possibilities of having a benchtop drill press. One of the few, though. Anyways, what we need to do next is to drill the hole for the insert, and this is what that cap screw is going to fit into so that we can tighten down the cap iron. Well, in this case, just the cap. So, for the plans, it says that you want this at least 1 3/4 inches centered from the very tip of the plane. So I went ahead and I drew my dot and I centered it according to the material. And then we take a 3/8 inch bit, and I'm going to use a Forstner bit here, and we're going to drill the hole that will go down. Now, one thing is, where that 1 3/4 is, we have to be very careful not to blow out the bottom. And it turns out that, let's see if I can do this just the right way, that screw, the inset screw, is going to fit just within that range. So we've got to be very, very careful, like I said, not to blow out the bottom. If we blow out the bottom, you know what? It happens. I don't really think it'll affect the bottom of the sole of the plane. I don't think it's going to have that much of an effect on the work. So we're going to be careful though anyway. So I went ahead and I preset my stop. I got everything lined up. And it'd be nice if I had a little clamp here, but I don't. So here we go. We're going to go ahead and turn on the press. And we're going to hope that that stop works the way we want it to. All right, no blowout on the bottom side. And now we just need to put in this inset screw. Let's see here. Where is my... Fortunately, I don't have... All right, well, I'm going to have to play with this a little bit. We'll get this all set in place. I don't have the little turny thing to move it, so I'm going to need a bigger screwdriver. But when we come back, this will be in place, and we're pretty much almost done at this point. All right, everybody, you know what? When it comes down to it, our chisel plane is pretty much ready to go. Got the insert nut put in place. It sits a little proud of the surface, but you know what? The blade is not going to have any problem with it whatsoever. Now, the next thing we need to do to finish up the project is to make the cap iron itself, or just the cap. And this one comes in at about, I've got mine just a little over 3 inches long. It's probably about 3 1/4. And what I ended up doing was just taking it from remnants, once again, from the wedge that we got when we cut the piece with the jig. And just spent a little time with the smoothers and kind of got it into the shape I needed at about the thickness I wanted. According to the plans, we needed to drill a hole to accommodate the screw about 1 1/2 inches back. And one other thing is the cap isn't going to sit flush on the blade. It needs to be on a little bit of an angle to help apply more pressure down at the tip. So they recommended that we attach like a little spacer on the bottom. This one's still kind of gluing up, so I don't want to play around with it too much. Should be about 1/16 of an inch. This one is obviously not 1/16. It's a little bit thicker. So once the glue sets up, I'll be able to knock it down a little bit to closer to that 1/16 of an inch size that we need. But essentially this baby is all set. So let's go ahead and put the blade in place. We'll put that cap on. We've got our washer, and then we have the screw that's going to hold on to it. You can get little caps that will fit into these set screws and make it just a little bit easier. I put one on before, but I needed to apply maybe a little bit more adhesive or something to hold it in place permanently. But this is going to work out perfectly fine. It's easy to lock it down. And the nice thing is, because it's a wooden plane, if I want to advance the blade, I just have to tap the back with the pull it backwards. I can tap the blade itself with a mallet, and that will advance it as I need it, or I can tap the back, and that will draw it backwards. And really, when it comes down to it, this baby is ready to go. At the most, the original plans recommended maybe routing in some grooves in the side to make it a little bit easier to hold on to. I will definitely be knocking down the edges because they're really harsh on the hand. Because as you're using this, I want to put all my pressure here at the back, because like I said before, the blade wants to dive down into the material. So we need to make sure that it stays level and we have more pressure back here than there. And let me tell you something, this baby is ready to go. And again, pretty much almost no cost whatsoever. The blade is the only thing I needed to purchase, plus the inset screws and everything like that. At the most, I maybe put like $40 into this whole entire thing. But you know what? I could have easily used a blade that I had sitting around from my other block planes. So anyways, though, I am ready to use this. I think I just need to give the blade a little honing. And I already got a project that I need to use this on. Remember, chisel planes are for refining, not for rough work. So I think I'm just going to knock those down a little bit and... this baby's ready to roll. I'm pretty excited about that. So anyways, I hope you enjoy this. If you have any questions about it, you know how to get a hold of me, mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com. And like I said, I'll make sure to have the links in there for the fine woodworking article that this originally came from. It's a much older one. And thank you to all of you who had sent it to me because you knew that that's the one I was talking about. Again, it was really easy. And honestly, once I got the jig set up, maybe 3-4 hours at the most, and I've got a great plane. Now that I've built this one, you know what? I'm thinking a couple of those Krennoff size or style ones, or who knows? Maybe we'll see. We got a couple other things. I got a couple of blocks over there. So, yeah. Anyways, though, okay, enough. I'll be talking to all of you. Straight greens and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.